Hi everyone, I'm Michelle Wyman. I have the privilege of serving as the Executive Director of the National Council for Science and the Environment. Our mission is focused specifically on increasing the value and use for science and environmental decision making without politicizing the science. Welcome to the NCSE Science Dialogues, our first ever today, produced in association with Planet Forward. The NCSE Science Dialogues highlight leaders and experts who work in science and politics, government and industry, and share in common a strong value for science and its role in society, and specifically environmental policy and decision-making. To put it simply, NCSE facilitates a feedback loop between the scientists and decision-makers to increase access, use of science to fortify durable, evidence-informed decisions. Planet Forward founder and NCSE board member Frank Sesno is a renowned journalist and political analyst. Most recently, Frank's work is focused on the power of story and its ability to accelerate and deepen the understanding and use of science by people from all walks of life. Frank, given your experience with the election season behind us and a new cast of public servants readying to take office at all levels of government, how do you think we can harness this political movement and anchor science as a primary asset to a policymaker, regardless of their political party or belief system?
Well, first of all, Michelle, thank you for having me and thank you for launching Science Dialogues. I think this is really important and exciting. I also want to applaud your optimism that the election season is behind us, because we may just be in perpetual political motion these days. But presuming that everything goes the way we think it is going to go, I think there's going to be a really fascinating resurgence of interest in science and in bringing science into policymaking. Certainly President-elect Biden has said so, and a number of Republicans have indicated, whether it's COVID, whether it's GMO, whether certainly in some cases it's climate change, that science has a vital role to play. And what I think we're going to see now is a public that's hungry for that, a science community that very much wants to propel that in the way that it can. And that's not necessarily an easy thing to do, because some scientists are more comfortable and some science organizations with what they may perceive as advocacy than others. But the way I think it's going to play out as a narrative is there's going to be a new story to tell here. And it can be a good one and an exciting one. And that is, how do discoveries get put in place, get incorporated into policy so that everybody's a winner? The science community for having done the work and discovered the knowledge, the policymakers for having answered problems, solved problems, trying to make progress on the things that we know are out there, and the general public for what they see. Whether it's going to the space station or coming up with, you know, affordable renewable energy, or figuring out the crops that we're going to grow that can feed a hotter, drier planet, certainly in many places, that's science. That's discovery. And that's exciting.
Thank you so much. I couldn't agree with you more. You know, every month, even more frequently right now, we see science showing up again and again, and it offers really a stabilizing element during really uncertain times. And it also gives hope. We saw that this weekend with the launch of astronauts to the space station through a private mechanism. And we see that as we all look towards the hopeful of evolution of a vaccine specifically for COVID-19.
Yeah, I think if I may, Michelle, I think that's an incredible opportunity. Because what people are hearing and what they will hear again and again and again will be several things relating to science. One, the miracle of doing it at all. We have this horrific pandemic, and our science, our medicine can address that. It can save lives. It can keep you healthy. And literally everyone on the planet is going to want to tune into that one. Secondly, the science behind it, the speed with which this was done, is breathtaking. And that too is a powerful story. And then finally, people are going to be hearing about this and they're going to be experiencing it, not through a politician, not through some nameless or unknown columnist or pundit, but through their doctor or their pharmacy or another human being who's going to say, do you want this vaccine? Because it will protect you and your family. That too is a powerful story that comes to people through trusted sources in their communities that they know. And it will have the effect for the vast majority, not everybody, of reinforcing belief and understanding that science is an exceptionally positive force.
That's absolutely right. I think it's also to your point of story and history. We are all living in history right now. This is an historical year, an historical experience. And for every single person, we are creating our own story by virtue of living through this together. So I think that there will be a lot of outcomes from this year, not least of which will include a new value for the role that science plays across society. And so let me kind of pick up on that a bit. You often reiterate you just have the power of story. Given that the world's most pressing environmental challenges, climate change, biodiversity loss, diminishing natural resources, just to name a few, are global, though the impacts and the consequences vary widely based on place, based on circumstance, based on the people that are affected in the ecosystems. How do you think that story can help diffuse cultural differences and engage people in the uptake of solutions, which need to occur at a breathtaking pace and scale to affect the level of change we need to see? And if we use the example of the development and the discovery around a vaccine, if we could mirror that in our response to climate change, it would be extraordinary. So how do you really see story playing a role in all of this?
I'm big on analogies and stories are born of those sometimes. You know, we've just been through a pandemic that's affected human beings, but the planet is sick too. And that comparison works. And just as science and a vaccine has helped us, we hope, or is going to help us avoid catastrophe and avoid death and avoid sickness, same to the planet. I think add to that are now the extreme weather events, the sea level rise, the droughts, the fires that are happening around the world and we share. I just did, not too long ago, we Planet Forward has a series that we're doing with PBS on their climate portal called Peril and Promise. And I just spoke, for example, with a woman in Australia who has lived through the brush fires there. And in Australia, over the course of a little more than a year, vast territory, the equivalent of entire country, the country of Syria, burned. And this woman, Carol Duncan is her name, her father nearly died. He lost everything in the fire. And she went to work working with fire refugees, which is another form of climate refugees. Why did I go to Australia? I went to Australia to tell that story because we've just experienced the same thing in the western part of the United States. I could have gone out west to tell that story, but I wanted to show people, and I wanted for people to hear from somebody with a slight accent who sounds like a neighbor,
right,
that this is a global phenomenon and that fire doesn't care what language you speak, where you live. It's going to burn you out if it comes. Creating this global identity, creating empathy with another person, and that's what you do through storytelling, through the characters you create or whose stories you tell, you try to create some kind of empathic relationship. And I think that that's where the opportunities are. Look at a small child. It really doesn't matter where that small child is. Small children are always powerful, innocent, immense potential characters, and people feel for them. So it's hard to do because there are people who look and sound very differently than you. It's hard to do when you're living a life that may be a hard scrabble life and the idea of thinking about climate change or sustainability or what's going to happen 20, 30, 50, 100 years from now is way over the horizon. But it's a process. We've seen movement in polling in this country. And I think that we're on the threshold of some very interesting, exciting action.
So Frank, I'm gonna take you back to your journalistic roots.
Uh-oh.
And as we close out today, I'm gonna put you on the spot. Very much appreciate you being here today. Thank you so much for the work that you do, for the inspiration that you provide, and your leadership, not only to our community at the National Council for Science and the Environment, having the vision to found Planet Forward and teaching all of us the power of story. Let me leave all of you with this from Frank. So Frank, if you could write a headline capturing the moment in time we find ourselves in today, what would it be?
Humanity seizes the moment. That would be the headline. The headline would be that people realize that we share one beautiful planet in space. We don't have an option yet. We're not going to go colonize Mars in our time. This place is a place of immense beauty and balance, but it's also in peril. And we can summon our unbelievable ingenuity. We defy gravity every day. And we can together address the problems of plastic and pollution and energy and water, because we've already done it. That would be the headline I would write. That would be that is the story that I pursue. And it is where the need is, the urgency is, and the inspiration resides. I really believe that.
And I would add to it, it's also where science can fortify and underscore all of what you just articulated.
Science is
behind. Has been and will continue.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right. All right. Thank you so much, Frank. Thanks for joining me today. I look forward to working with all of you and seeing what the future looks like.
Thank you, Michelle. Great pleasure.